Welcome to a quick introduction to RStudio. Check the info cards to see how to acquire and install RStudio. The basic layout consists of four parts. On the bottom left-hand corner you have the console, which will give you the results for analytical tests you conducted. On the top right-hand corner are the most important tabs, environment and history. The environment tab shows which data frames and objects are loaded and can be addressed with your code. The history tab shows the commands you used, quite similar to the console, just minus the output. The bottom right-hand corner shows various tabs you will most likely use frequently. The Files tab, as the name indicates, shows a file explorer which allows you to navigate to certain files in or outside your working directory. Use the little gear symbol for further options. The Plots tab also speaks for itself, showing you plots and graphics you created. The Packages tab shows you which packages are installed and currently loaded, indicated by a checkmark in front. Installing and updating can also be done from here or via the console. The Help tab is particularly useful if you are looking for arguments for certain functions or even packages themselves within the R documentation. You will rather sooner than later find yourself browsing this section. Trust me on this one. Finally, in the top left-hand corner you can write your script, which can later be saved and loaded again. You can start a new script by clicking on File and select New File and then R Script. Once you have written a bit of code, you can save it by clicking either the floppy disk symbol or choose File and Save. Loading works the same way. In case you have a larger project, you might consider creating said project to have your scripts and data in one place. If you are the type of person that prefers using keyboard shortcuts, you can find it under Tools and Keyboard Shortcuts Help. The global options can also be found under Tools. In the General section, you can select a different R version in case you have several installed, the default working directory and so forth. The code and console sections are about customized coding. You don't need to change anything in particular, since the default settings work pretty well. The appearance section is particularly helpful if you are looking for a darker theme that reduces eye strain. Simply choose an editor's theme that suits you. While you're at it, you can also change the editor font and font size and the zoom. The latter helps if you sit in front of a larger monitor. If you want to fully customize your colors, give the link in the description a try. Finally, the pane layout section can be used to customize the four-part layout I mentioned earlier. Again, the default settings are usually a safe bet. A final pro tip are the so-called cheat sheets. They can be found under Help and Cheat Sheets. And you can see that there is a variety of said sheets. For beginners, dplyr and ggplot2 are good starting points for data transformation and visualization respectively. Selecting one will open a browser and automatically download a PDF file, which is literally stuffed with almost all important functions of those packages. Finally, you can browse all existing cheat sheets. If you have any further questions regarding RStudio, don't hesitate and use the comment section under this video.